And debate number two. Reports now seem to suggest that the government is working on re-energizing, reviving the proposal to amend the Tobacco Act. Essentially, the government is looking at bringing in stricter norms to try and curb smoking, to try and curb the use of tobacco, especially as it becomes a bigger concern for the widespread use amongst our youngsters, amongst minors. And one of the proposals that is being considered is that there should be a ban on the sale of loose cigarettes. That's usually in other countries across the world taken as a measure to stop or to reduce the consumption of tobacco amongst minors. Those are the students, you know, youngsters, high school going students are the ones who would probably buy a loose cigarette because they can't really carry a pack for the fear of getting caught by their teachers, by the school authorities or their parents. But over and above that, will this really help in curbing smoking? Is it even practical in a country like ours? But even the basic rules, simple norms that you're not allowed to sell cigarettes in and around educational institutions barely get implemented. What will work in our country? That's the big debate. Let's have our constructive conversation. Let's say good evening to our panelists who are joining us on this debate. Dr. Sajeela Maini, President of Tobacco Control Foundation of India. Dr. U.S. Vishal Rao, Senior Oncologist, Healthcare Global and Member of the High Power Committee on Tobacco Control and Cancer Control for Karnataka Government. Anshu Morse, a comedian joining us from Gurgaon. And Ashim Sanyal, COO for Consumer Voice. So we have a varied panel here to bring us different viewpoints. Let me start with Dr. Vishal Rao. Dr. Vishal Rao, give us a sense on, you know, whether this helps, has it helped abroad, and is it implementable in our country, where there is literally a paan ka dukaan selling cigarettes at every nook and corner?
Yeah, Tanvi, can you hear me?
Yes, I can.
So Tanvi, I think the larger debate that has been brought into the discussion here is whether it can be implemented, and if so, why should it be implemented? So I would like to answer the first part initially, that why it needs to be implemented and why governments are now looking at it seriously. There is two aspects to this. One is the legal aspect, the other is the health aspect. And then there is a third aspect, that is the revenue aspect. Now, quickly speaking, 85% of the cigarettes or tobacco products, that is like beedi, sold in India are sold loose, primarily cigarettes. 85% to 90% of the sale of cigarettes happen loose. And this is a very, very serious concern because it violates Section 7, Section 8 and Rule 3E of the COTPA Act, which clearly mandates that every single person who's a consumer of a particular product should have a packeted warning on the cigarette pack. So the packeted warning is mandatory as per the Section 7. So no cigarette can be sold without a warning on the packet, which is as per the Consumer Law and as per the COTPA Act. Now, based on that, this particular section, that is loose cigarette sale, actually violates the very premise of Section 7 and Section 8 of the COTPA Act, and hence defeats the very purpose of actually the health, packeted health warning, the package health warning on cigarette packs. Number two is the aspect, that is the legal aspect. The second aspect, like I told you, is the health aspect, that 85% of these cigarettes are sold loose, and government of India today spends about 1 lakh crore rupees on 4 health related aspects of tobacco, which is cancer, which is lung diseases, heart diseases, and tuberculosis. There are 4 of such diseases. The government of India spends about 1 lakh crore per year. And number three is that the majority of the tax plasticity, so government of India through the GST and others have levied taxes on cigarettes. Now the idea behind this is that it has been known world over that if you double the taxes, the government can triple its revenues and half the debts. So taxation has been known as one of the most strongest weapons used in the war on tobacco control, and which is what has been endorsed even by the World Health Organization. loose cigarette sale defeats the purposes of taxation, because every time that you actually sell these cigarettes loose, the overall impact of actually selling the cigarettes and reducing its sale is defeated.
Okay.
And that's why it's important to take the legal, the health, as well as the revenue angle.
Okay. All right. Let me bring in Anshu Mohr. Anshu Mohr, what do you think? Is this a good step? Will it help in effectively the battle that the government is fighting?
No, of course, a good step for sure. Anything that reduces tobacco consumption would be a good step. But honestly, my only issue with this right now is the execution part of it.
Right.
Like you said in the intro, there is a cigarette shop literally every 200 meters in this country, right? So, and we all know that at that level, at that frequency, it's very difficult to regulate all of this. So that, number one, is a big issue. I'm not such a fan of the labeling which is done, to saying all that horrific photo which comes on these packs. I don't think anybody looked at those photos and said, I should quit smoking.
Right.
It is required by law, so it should be put there. But that should not be the reason why loose cigarettes are not being sold. I would still subscribe to the point that, children, especially school students and college students, it's easier for them to just buy loose cigarettes.
Yes.
That, is a more plausible reason to kind of do this. But the execution part still remains an issue. I don't think it can be executed. There are bigger health issues in this country. Street food, for example, massive health issues. There are more people who eat food than who smoke. I don't think that's been sorted out. So while the government is taking this move and should take this move, but they should have a very, very clear plan of how to execute this.
Okay, Dr. Maini, let me come to you. And, many of these suggestions were also part of a draft in 2014. That draft got junked because there was they said that they need to review some of the proposals which are in the draft. And the argument presented by many at that point was that if you ban the sale of loose cigarettes, then people will start smoking beedis, which are equally, if not worse, as far as harmful effects are concerned, or that there will be a black market and people will start charging more for loose cigarettes, and that's not helpful either. It doesn't help solve the problem that you're tackling. So do you believe you need a larger comprehensive plan that includes a crackdown of some kind on BDs before you just, bring about a rule on loose cigarettes?
Definitely, I believe in this. Actually, first of all, I would like to congratulate the government. At least they're working in the area of anti-tobacco law. At least some steps are taking care. I have always been an advocate of the availability factor. So at least something is being happening, one, and the intention of the government is very clear. The intention of the government is to curb the tobacco abuse or the tobacco menace. But definitely, very importantly, cigarette is only 16% of the total tobacco consumption. If you increase the prices, if you make this debate was earlier also. It arose in 2014. I was in one of the discussions then, and again it has come in 2019. Yeah, so it didn't work at that time also, and that time also I had a mixed reaction. One is intention is clear. Second is what would be the impact. Very importantly, cigarette is only 16%. If you increase the prices, the price rise has never worked. Yeah, we all know the price rise has never worked, because I have seen the cigarette prices, the packet of the cigarette prices have been doubled. Yeah?
Yes.
So in India, there's a variety. It's like it's basically beedi population, it's like tobacco population. There will be a shift to the higher brand cigarette, to the lower brand cigarette, the cheaper version. Now they're cheaper version. It's not only 300 rupees a packet. It can be even 50 rupees a packet. It is there in the market. If you see a vendor selling, I know people. Cigarettes are as cheaper as 10 rupees a packet and 50 rupees a packet. So we have different variety of things. Now, this will have an impact on the initial users, the people who are experimental smokers. But for the regular smokers, it doesn't have an impact. One, because the regular smoker would not actually do, he will adjust his stuffs. And I haven't seen, I am in Gangaram Hospital, I haven't seen anybody falling short of finances because of his addiction or stuff. He always has money for his addiction. person. Where there's a will, there's always a way. Yeah. So with this, what will happen? What population are we targeting? Are we targeting the low-income group? The low-income group would shift over to the cheaper versions and to the beedi smoking. And for the higher-income group, it will actually, the higher-income group is the cigarette in the youngsters is no more fashionable. It's more of the e-cigarette, the Juul thing that is fashionable, and the hookah smoking that is the in thing. Yeah. And one more important thing that the government needs to actually address is that what comprises a pack. They should actually address one very important part. Like tomorrow, the cigarette companies can come in and make a two cigarette. They can roll in two cigarettes and say this is a packet. They can roll in four cigarettes and say this is a packet. So what decides a packet? Is 10 cigarettes a packet, or is two cigarettes a packet, or is five cigarettes a packet? So they can even think wider. So one very important point that I want to make, government should address this, and the implementation part with the vendor every 50 yards. You cannot implement it. It's very difficult for you to implement it, one. And second, because earlier the sections of the COPTA Act is still a mockery. It's not been implemented till date. It has to be a complete ban that I'm always advocating, a complete ban. And actually, the availability needs to be addressed. The government is looking at sometimes the advertisement, sometimes the availability factor, sometimes the
yes. So the I think what they are now looking at work. And they hopefully and will be
so
part of a comprehensive plan.
So
and
many
I
Chinese cigarettes and so many...
Yes, I agree with you. And, you know, ideally there should be a comprehensive plan which says that in certain areas, not even at airports, not even at, you know, various public places, should you be allowed to smoke. They will look at stricter laws when it comes to advertising for tobacco. They will look at higher fine for those who've been caught smoking.
We have smoke rooms in airport.
But at the end of the day, all of this will only work if it is implemented on ground. And existing rules barely get implemented. Bihar government last year banned loose cigarettes. I don't think it's working at all in Bihar as far as banning sale of loose cigarettes is concerned. So the implementation part, yes, is a big challenge. Let me go across to Ashim Sanyal.
And very importantly,
Dr. Maini, I'll come back to you in just a bit. Let me just bring in our fourth voice as well. Ashim Sanyal, CEO of Consumer Voice. Mr. Sanyal, what do you think should be done for this entire battle against tobacco to really be effective?
See, having working in the tobacco control area for the last one decade, two factors have come up very clearly globally and in India in terms of tobacco control, and that is all forms of tobacco. One is the higher pricing, and second is the availability. Now, when you're addressing an issue of higher pricing, it means basically it should be priced at a level where the common man cannot reach. So that addresses the issue of cigarettes and the lower strata of the society who will not be attracted to higher prices of a cigarette. The second aspect is easy availability. You can term it in any way. Loose cigarette basically means easy availability, and therefore it is a temptation for youngsters to buy these loose cigarettes, as you yourself mentioned. And loose cigarette basically is in contravention of COTPA indirectly, not directly. And it is important that COTPA amendment is brought about in a very holistic way in terms of all the factors bringing in. A speaker just said that, you know, there are various kind of tobacco products. Now, we all know that because of simple reason that when the GST 28% sin tax was being calculated, we made our plea very clear that all forms of tobacco should be brought under the 28% GST higher slab. That was done by the government. So very proactive government, must thank them for that. Now, question is basically, if you are selling loose cigarettes, then you are actually avoiding what is called in principle the pictorial warning, which is something which was introduced after scientific investigation across the globe that it has an effect, a negative effect on the buyers. And please do not forget, in India now we have also introduced a toll-free number for tobacco quit. Now these are factors that do not affect loose tobacco sale or loose cigarette sales. It may, the cigarette percentage may be 14%, it may be 18%, doesn't matter. We are controlling one particular factor by just stopping the sale of loose cigarette. And most of us know that many of the states have anyway banned sale of loose cigarette with the conviction that it is harmful, and especially to the youngsters. And this is the area where we need to concentrate upon implementation of COTPA law for controlling cigarettes or tobacco habits within the youth and the children. Now, this is fast catching up, and probably this COTPA amendment bill will address most of this issue. As I said, it's a wholesome issue, and agreeing to completely what Vishal says, it is an issue which addresses three or four chapters of tobacco control, and we are not saying that. In fact, it's WHO who says that.
Correct.
It's a global tobacco control fraternity who is saying that. Correct. So loose cigarette sale is one of the components, not all the components, but one of the components, but a very important component of tobacco control, especially because it is affecting the youth today. And secondly, it is making tobacco products affordable.
Okay, well, if it's affecting the youth and it's being done with that intent, great idea for sure. But at the end of the day, like I said, cigarettes are still available around every possible school, every possible college. I don't think youth have a problem about access. In fact, if at all, it's not just cigarettes. Drugs is a big problem with the youngsters of our country, and that's easily accessible and available to them. And that's a bigger battle as well. But Anshu Moore wanted to come in. Go ahead, please, Anshu.
Yeah, I just wanted to again reiterate this point of executing these kind of things, right? It might be a very different view, but I seriously don't believe that increasing prices, etc., alienate a few percentage of the population who can't afford, but they will go in for cheaper brand cigarettes. You have to understand cigarettes are available across the entire price spectrum. It's almost to say that those who can afford can die. But we'll keep increasing prices. So I don't think those kind of things really make any difference, frankly speaking. It is the execution. How do you regulate this to a point where those who are selling it are liable to a great extent, right? If it's not a fee, it's not a fine of $500 or $1,000 or $2,000, it should be a much, much higher fine that comes in for those who are selling it. And then at the ground level, and obviously because of the scale of the number of vendors who are there, it will be an issue. But, you know, at least you got to get the fear in of a massive fine. It's just not like, it shouldn't be in like thousands of bucks. It should be enough for people to shut down their shop if they have to. That's the level of fine you have to put for selling loose cigarettes if you have to implement this.
Okay.
Otherwise, this is one of those things which, you know,
before we wrap this
will
up,
happen as a half measure.
Yes. Dr. Rao, go ahead.
So Tanvi, I think Anshu has raised two interesting points, and I'll just like to respond to them. One is the individual belief we have about whether something works or not. And generally, policies and governments look at the larger science. So what WHO did was, they have actually done something called as the GATT study, the Global Adult Tobacco Survey, which is done across the world. And in India, over the last 5 years, they have studied how has policy impacted it, and it has led to a 17% reduction in tobacco consumption. If you ask Karnataka, in the last 5 years, it has reduced 7% reduction in tobacco consumption, which roughly translates to about 20 lakh lives saved. So what this data showed us, this is the WHO validated data, which was done in a very intensive manner and is available publicly. It showed us that just by putting a warning label on the packet, more than 50% of the tobacco users thought about quitting tobacco. And I'm not talking about three or four of us panelists who don't use tobacco, but I'm talking about a large survey that covered crores of people,
okay,
which said that every time that a tobacco consumer looked at the packet, he thought about quitting in 50% of the time.
I'm very surprised, and I think there are two other panelists who are surprised, but perhaps that data needs to be further looked into. I personally never come across anybody who is a regular smoker and actually wanted to quit because of those ugly pictures. Any step that could help should be taken, as long as there is no further negative impact of that step. Any policy that helps in reducing consumption of tobacco and helps in saving lives should be taken, should be tried, as long as there isn't a negative impact. And that's perhaps what governments of the day need to look into. Fact of the matter is, many times in the past, proposals have been made, drafts have been drawn, and then abandoned and thrown into the garbage bin because some or the other lobby including powerful connections with sitting ministers and leaders. At various points of time, those part of the tobacco committees have been used to junk all of these. So we must keep in mind that when the policy is finally drawn, it is only done keeping in mind the user, the citizen of this country, and not the tobacco makers. That has to be essentially kept in mind. Otherwise, all the policy discussions will begin and end with virtually no impact on this battle against tobacco. Completely out of time. Thank you so much for joining us on this debate.